Hey guys, I'm Mina Zeta with Sidewalker Daily. And in today's video, I want to talk about how to work with brands if you are a nano influencer. Nano influencer, 10,000 followers or under. I'm talking to you. I'm talking to my smaller creators, those just starting, those that maybe have been doing it for a while and just hover around a number under 10,000. This video is for you. If you guys are new to our channel, welcome, welcome. I love talking about working with brands, pitching to brands. If there was one thing I could say about our agency, Sidewalker Daily, it would be just that. Like, our signature thing is helping creators work with brands. You can look at our success stories. You can look at all the reviews. That's what we do. And that's why I realized today's video, I wanted to talk to those in our community or to the newbies about ways that you as a nano influencer can start working with brands, can start pitching, start doing what you want, which is most likely working with some of your favorite brands, right? One of the biggest misconceptions in pitching is that you have to have a certain number of followers. This just is not true anymore. The market has changed. You guys, the influencer marketing industry is booming. There's room for everyone at all levels. And before I go into today's video and all the tips I'm going to be sharing on pitching, I want to set the landscape for you guys to understand. If a brand only has a $10,000 budget, let's just say, to work with an influencer, they're not gonna go to some celebrity YouTuber, so some celebrity TikToker, because they wouldn't be able to afford more than what, one post, right? So when you are nano, you're actually, or micro, you're actually like in a really good place to work with brands that just have smaller budgets. It doesn't mean that they're less well-known. They could be, they could also be local brands or brands just starting out. And this is to give you guys like some background. When I sign on a brand, right, to do their influencer marketing campaign, it could be a global brand and they've just never done influencer marketing before. So their budgets are small because they're still scared and they're still testing. And that's why you, the nano influencer, someone that's first starting off, is in a really good position to go after that budget. So it's really a win-win for brands that are also just starting their influencer marketing to team up with those nano creators. So the first tip, let's dive in, is really your goal and your focus of someone who is a nano influencer, nano creator, is to focus on networking, okay? People want to send cold pitches and they want to just like, hey, work with me, pay me 10 grand, pay me 5 grand, pay me whatever. But guys, it's literally like the example of that I always share, that like if you are at a bar, let's just say, and you want to talk to someone, are you just going to go up to them right away and ask for their phone number without talking first or chatting or finding a relevant something you guys have in common? Again, there's so many creators that are so hungry to work with brands that they skip all the levels, and networking should be something that is at the top of your to-do list. What I mean by networking, setting up those virtual copies, you know, reaching out to brands and adding value to them, not asking for anything, just kind of like, you know, warming up the lead. And this is something I talk about all the time in my Pitching to Brands Master course. And I show those strategies, how to warm up the lead so that you can then go in and effectively pitch. We don't want to come off too hard or too strong. You know, whether you're asking your brand to get on a live with you, or if you are, you know, reaching out and saying that you're doing an IG, you know, stories and you want to talk about them, can they provide you a quote? Whatever. Warm up those leads, network, go to conferences, put yourself in the right place in the right time so that you can start to A, treat yourself like a business, and B, meet people that are eventually going to pay you. Now, another massive tip for the nano influencers out there that want to work with brands is to create content that serves a purpose when it comes to pitching. So what I mean by this is you really want to create content that you can show a brand that is example of your work. Okay, as someone who is on the brand side, I get emails from influencers all the time. And I can tell you that emails are just that, emails. They're just words on a piece of paper. There is nothing like seeing your idea come to life, giving an example. And that's why a lot of times, like, so many nano influencers and nano creators, like, they just create without intention, without purpose. They don't know their niche. They're just kind of posting. But then how is a brand going to actually want to reach out to you or want to work with you if, one, they don't know what you stand for, and two, they can't visually see the type of content you can make for them? I'll give you guys an example. This week I am preparing an influencer campaign for a client, and I was going on Instagram and doing scouting, and I can tell you within seconds I knew who I wanted to reach out to and who I didn't. And oftentimes the person I would want to reach out to 9 times out of 10 had content that I could very clearly see my client A, enjoying, B, liking, or C, reusing. I could see my client reusing that content, which is to say that means if you as a NANO influencer, if you have content that the brand wants to reuse, it's setting you up to win and to get that partnership, okay? So if you're out there, you're listening, NANO influencer, NANO creator, create content that serves an example. It's one of my favorite tips, and it goes a long way. And I just wanna take a second here and shout out some past students that have done my pitching course. Brittany with the Jet Setting Blonde, I think she's hovering around 2,000 followers. She's gotten paid by brands for content. And again, you know, I see this time and time again. I have Nikisa, another creator who I love. She's in the travel space as well. Also getting paid for her content, took our pitching course, has left us an amazing testimonial, both of them. And again, the success stories that I've had are so many, and so many creators being those NANO influencers, 10,000 followers and below. So if you're interested in learning more, you can check out all our success stories and learn more about our pitching course that can help you start getting paid once and for all for the work that you wanna do with brands. No more gifted stuff, actually starting to get paid. This is my sweet spot, and this is what I love to teach. So my third big tip, guys, is testing your influence. You are an influencer, right? You're a creator. You have social media presence. Well, you need to test. Do people swipe up when you tell them to? Okay, how many clicks are you getting if you do a swipe up, for example? How many link views? If you do a giveaway, do people enter? Are you actually influential? Do you have true influence? If you're a NANO influencer, this is the type of stuff you wanna look at. And that's why your insights, guys, are so, so important, because you wanna go into your insights, review them, especially when you're putting together your media kit as a NANO. You need to lean into those metrics. You need to lean in and to say, yeah, you know, I did a giveaway. I was able to get 300 people to enter. That is valuable when you're pitching. Or going in and saying what the number of clicks were for a campaign that you did, whether it be even for yourself. Brands care about those type of metrics, those conversions. We want to see your selling ability, your power, your true influence. So as a creator, test, 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 and actually make sure that you have influence. And if you do, you are in an amazing position to pitch, because the proof is in the pudding. You can put all this information together in a really nice case study and use it as a pitching material. Another huge tip on working with brands as a NANO creator, a NANO influencer, this is like, I love this one, is really spending time nurturing your community and listening to them. Do they say to you, thank you so much for that recommendation, or I love that product, or I just booked my trip because of you. What is the sentiment? Are people actually coming to you and saying that you have, you know, that they did something because of you and it turned out really, really great? You wanna keep your audience, you know, talking to you. You need to have them talking to you, not just you talking to them. They need to come and talk to you. I can't tell you again, when someone comes to me and is like, Nina, I did what you said, you know, I bought the course, I'm in it, and boom, I got this, right? I am constantly listening to my students, their results, what works, what doesn't work. Refine, refine, refine. And the same thing for you guys. You guys need to be out there creating content and understanding, did you promote like a baby monitor and someone commented, just bought it? If yes, this is super important, because it's showing that not only one, that you have that influence that we talked about in the step before, but two, that people trust you. And as a NANO influencer, you need to really rely on that trust when it comes to working with brands. Now, I have said this in other videos. If you're new to my channel, you should really take a second and binge all my videos on working with brands, because I have a ton of them. Because like I said, that's exactly what we love to do here at Sidewalker Daily, is teach creators how to pitch and how to work with brands and get paid, most importantly. But one thing I'll always say is the importance of building a portfolio. If you're NANO, if you're small, you need to do the work. You need to, you know, take the 8 hours or whatever it's gonna take for you to put together a portfolio so that you have something to show the brands that you're trying to pitch content to, right? If you wanna say, hey, I can create reels for you on a monthly basis, you need to have a portfolio that shows video content. Or if you're going to a brand and saying, I wanna create all your still photography for the month, how are you gonna show them that, right? So don't forget the importance of doing the work upfront so that you can pitch and get those brand deals, have a portfolio. And my last piece of advice to the NANO influencers out there, to those creators that are still really getting started and looking to pitch and work with brands, is think of this as a little bit as an internship, right? You are just starting out, just like anything in the world. You need to go through a lot of tests. And I don't mean you need to get the experience in terms of hours. Like, I don't think just because you have 5 years, it makes you more experienced. It's how many times have you been able to test your pitches and see, okay, what works, what doesn't. If, you know, you wanna be able to go through those patterns to understand that this is kind of like an internship. You're supposed to be learning and soaking it in. And don't forget the importance, nanos and micros, just like in any business, you need to invest in yourself to really lift off. I've invested in myself so much throughout my career. Anyone that here is successful will tell you, invest in yourself, learn, grow, test, repeat. Like I said, we have an entire course, 11 hours, that teaches how to pitch to brands. And not only does it teach, the results from the students, which are available for you guys to read, are there. The testimonials are there. The results is there. So again, it may be time for you as a creator, Nano, this is something you're really serious about and you really want to do. Invest in yourself, learn so that you can start pitching. I am telling you, as someone on the brand side, we are paying nano influencers, we are paying micro influencers. Nano influencers are more and more part of a brand's budget now than they were ever, because people want the smaller influencers, they want the niche communities, they're able to see the results better. It's a win-win. So if you haven't started pitching in your nano, let's start. This is the time for you. And again, guys, if you have any questions, comments, or anything that you want to learn about, let me know in the comments below. Fuel my fire, like this video, subscribe to our channel, and I will see you guys in the next video.